Please welcome now James Lafferty, the leader of the Virginia Anti-Sharia Task Force. The mission of the Virginia Anti-Sharia Task Force is to oppose and to assist others in resisting the implementation of the radical, barbaric, and anti-constitutional Sharia law in Virginia and everywhere in America. James Lafferty.
Good afternoon. I'm proud to be here with so many people who have made such a sacrifice. Maura Daugherty died here 10 years ago while working for Cantor Fitzgerald. I never met Maura, but I know her mother. Her mother is part of our coalition. Her mother has endless energy in fighting this, as do all of you. It's good today to take some time and to mourn what America lost that day. We lost brilliant people, young people whose lives were just starting out. God knows what they would have accomplished. The same goes for our military. The same goes for the firefighters and police who perished that day. It is good to reflect on that. It is good to say a prayer for them, and that's worth maybe 10 minutes. Then we must get back into the struggle. We are engaged in a daily struggle for the soul of America. Just as courage was here that day, evil was here too. And what we are engaged in is a struggle of free people throughout the world, from the men and women of our armed forces to the men and women of the Israel Defense Force. We stand shoulder to shoulder against this evil. I'm consulting right now on a campaign in Africa, and I'm proud to say there are people in countries in Africa who are standing up to Sharia. I live in the Wahhabi corridor in Virginia. I live 3 miles from the Dar al-Hijra Mosque, which is where the 9/11 attack was planned. When I stop for a Starbucks in the morning, when I'm taking my kid to school, I stop in the same restaurant where they sketched out the Pentagon attack on a napkin. Every day I see this evil. It is growing in my community. It's growing in just about every American community. I'm asking you, please get involved and be active in confronting this. We have to tell them no. They cannot do this to our country. Sharia is anti-constitutional. It is against natural law. It is not part of any legitimate religion. No religion does what Sharia does. I don't know of any who punishes people for not joining their religion, who threatens people and terrorizes them if they don't submit. We will not submit. I'm sure many of you are in partnership with people from Glock and with people from Mossberg and Beretta, and you're exercising your full Second Amendment rights. Because unless something changes dramatically in this country, that's the way we're headed. And my hope and prayer is that by some future November, America will have new leaders who understand why it's important to be an American and why it is important to stand up for it. I don't think any of us are confused about what's necessary to be an American, but I'm not so sure that the people at the White House right now know that. So let me say, as we are separated by time from what happened here, we will never be separated by distance. No matter how many years, we will carry what happened here and will carry the righteous anger that we should have over what was done to innocent Americans at this site. It is up to us to get up every morning and ask ourselves, what can we do today to help win the struggle for America's soul? Because that is what it is about. It is a spiritual battle. It is a political battle. And we need to fight it with all sincerity and with every energy we have. One last thing. The lack of mention of God at the ceremony today and the efforts to restrict the clergy. Sometimes I think that the current resident of the White House thinks that God bless America is a command that he is issuing to God. It's a prayer. It's maybe the only prayer that we're allowed to say in public buildings anymore, but it's a prayer. In my son's school in Virginia, only half the class stands up for the national anthem and the Pledge of Allegiance. We can't afford that. We cannot afford to raise a young generation of Americans who don't understand why we are Americans and what has happened. So, final point, fight. It's very simple, fight. This is not a time to talk. This is a time to run for office like the gentleman from North Carolina, to get out there and support people, to stand up to the politicians, and they're all taking money from the Saudis. Stand up to them and tell them no, and don't get them out of office. And I pray that from this day forward, God will continue to bless America. Thank you.